Hey Dragonauts, what's Dragonaut? Astral Slam back with another deck tech. We are looking at big Rakdos today, ramping up to play the big spells that we want to jam in the standard meta. Before I get into the deck tech, please remember to hit that subscribe button down below to stay up to date on all the latest standard and explorer decks going on in the meta. And with that, let's talk into ramping into our big things. What are we going to ramp into? Well, you can kind of see it already. The Portal to Phyrexia, clearing creatures, bringing stuff back. The Skitterbeam Battalion, putting 12 power onto the board to decimate your opponent's life total. The Cityscape Leveler, blowing up non-land permanents, unearthing to come back with big 8-8 body and trample. And the Phyrexian Flesh Gorger, that menace and lifelink with ward on power. Big threats, big problems, big things to spell the end for your opponent's days. We get to ramp there with the new mechanic in Brothers War, Power Stones. Power Stones, I think, are actually a little bit underplayed in some way. Getting Power Stones is advantageous if you are going in the artifact strategy, even just using them for other costed effects. So you can only use artifact like Power Stones to pay for artifact spells or additional cost of effects. They can't be used to cast non-artifact spells, which we're fine with. We only want to cast our big artifact spells like the portal. Portal is probably our best hit in this list. So we want to generate power stones. We want to get power stones and just ramp our way up. So starters, Thran Spider. ETBs, us and our opponent get a power stone. We care about us getting the power stone though. We are also playing Karn Living Legacy. I think Karn actually finds a really great home in this list, making a power stone, but also you can use your power stones to pay X amount of mana to look at cards at the top of your list and find an answer to whatever your opponent is doing to answer anything going on and just have the right plan of attack. And our last Power Stone generator comes in the form of the Visions of Phyrexia. Probably the best card in this deck for card advantage because it plays around Sheoldred. This doesn't let you draw, this exiles the top card of your library. And on a turn, if you don't play the card from exile, you make a tap Power Stone token. So like first turn this comes in, if you haven't played anything from exile, you immediately get a Power Stone token right away. So that's great. 4 mana, we get a cool enchantment. We already get a ramp piece. Love it. Next turn, start exiling the top card. So we get our draw, we get an exile. That's an extra card to dig further into the deck, finding answers to our opponent and making sure, you know, we don't take any life on potentially dangerous Sheoldreds that are going around. We also have some other ways to dig up card advantage here. Of course, Fable of the Mirrorbreaker, generating treasures is something we love to do. Discarding, kind of digging deeper and finding answers in our list. And Reflection is nice because of our Cityscape level and our Phyrexian Flesh Gorger. Making copies of an 8-8 is pretty sweet. Same with Flesh Gorger. We love life, right? And speaking to that card advantage method here, the Thran Spider. So you can pay 7 mana, look at the top card, 4 cards of your library, and reveal an artifact in them. Put that in your hand, the rest go in the bottom. So you can start digging down 4 cards at a time to just find a right artifact you need, put it into your hand, and use your power stones to cast that. And we love finding portals, we love Flesh Gorging Levelers, even Skitterbeam Battalion is great. But, you know, that's all nice and dandy to get up there, you've got to stay alive together, so you need some removal. Our early removal package is in the form of Disfigures, Go for the Throws, and Abrades. Abrade is going to let us deal with any creatures that are artifacts. Go for the Throw deals with the creatures that are not artifacts. And Disfigure just kind of gets rid of anything that is a 1 to 2 drop very nicely and lets you play around cards like Guardian of Nubinalia. So your opponent's not going to be able to discard to keep it indestructible. Instead, Guardian's just going to go gone. So it plays nicely around the indestructible effect, which is going to be a big problem for this deck. In addition with that, we've got Brotherhood's End, clearing the board and dealing 3, also blowing up smaller artifacts. Most of the time we don't want to use that though, that'll hit your Power Stone, so mostly this is going to hit 3 to each creature in Planeswalker. And our last big clear here, Burn Down the House, dealing 5 to everything. So you've got 6 board sweeps in the deck, you're running 7 removal, you're running roughly 9 pieces of ramp generation, in addition to the bigger removal pieces of Portal to Phyrexia, Cityscape Leveler, and whatever else you're bringing in from the sideboard. I mean, let's talk sideboard. We're in Rakdos. We've got to have some cool stuff, and we do. We have Voltage Surges, taking advantage of those artifact generation cards that we have, sacking one to deal 4 damage to something instead of 2. We have Obliterating Bolt, exiling a creature or a planeswalker when we kill it this way. An extra Brotherhood's End and Karn Silex. So all non-land permanents with mana value X or less are going to be gone and destroyed. Brotherhood's End clearing the board still nicely. When you're up against control matches, we've got Duresses and Pilfers. Attack the hand, take away their cards, while your Visions of Phyrexia is going to give you the card advantage. And kind of finishing it off, you know, Reckoning your Bank Busters, bringing in on that mid-range kind of love, so you'll be able to draw some extra cards, maybe have an early blocker when you draw your third one, but mostly for the guard draw. And the extra Flesh Gorger, which is just really nice to bring in against mid-range decks. When you're not so focused on the Skitterbeam, you more like the Flesh Gorger, because you can also prototype it out and have a good 3-3 blocker. So Dragonlings and Dragonauts, I hope you enjoy Big Rakdos and bringing your opponent to crumbles by playing the Portal to Phyrexia and Cityscape Lovers, literally leveling the playing field and taking out their resources.
This is a keeper.
Deathman in the Flame, and I'm here for it.
Deathman is here. Deathman. The Flame.
I mean, you're not exactly wrong.
But the Flame is ready to get through. The Flame will tell you brothers and friends and sisters and every in-betweens and theys and non-binary pals. The Flame sees you for you. And the Flame loves y'all. Man never dies, only the actors who betray him. The Flame does not like the Spirited Companion and goes for the removal. Flame is ready to get into the Visions of Phyrexia for ultimate value. The Flame thinks this is just a paltry, ambitious farmhand. Thinking the farmhand needs to get back and get ready for the Flame. When the Flame gets down the Visions of Phyrexia, the Flame is meaning business. The Visions are down and the Flame is ready. The Flame's plans slowly come together now. The Flame for sure knows that this is a mono-white control deck from the opponent, playing Wedding Announcements. The Flame seems to be mistaken. The Flame here is considering a burn down the house, just to quickly deal with the Sarah Paragon. The Flames are about to burn the house down.
Oh, my voice is not prepared for this tonight, apparently.
But the Flame holds steady with the Power Stone making.
If this makes it into YouTube.
Ah, the Flame's perfect draw. The Flame, never missing a beat, opts to play in Karn, the Living Legacy, for yet another Power Stone. If we must fight, I do not intend. The Flame's value is unparalleled, and the Flame is okay with that. The Flame now has 10 mana available. The Flame now simply needs to just draw a big critter. The Flames don't drop the heat for no one.
My Duff Flames.
The Flame is not able to draw because the card blocks. The Flame will now draw his card because he is not blocked anymore. Getting the perfect answer to everything, another Visions of Phyrexia. The Flame plays in a land, plays in a Visions, plays in a Disfigure. The Flame then ends the turn. The flame now drawing 3 cards a turn.
Well, Chris, thank you once again for that redemption of the flame. I think I'm going to have to drink more water before I do the flame more. Oh, goodness. So, I like where we're at. The only thing that worries me is if they have a farewell on the list, but... Finding a Phyrexia plus Urabrasker, you just start... I did think about Urabrasker for this list. And the funny thing, too, is, like, Urabrasker actually gets around Sheoldred, as does Visions of Phyrexia. I'll go to 13 here. That's fine. Like, we just get some card draw here, which is great. There's a portal. Look at that. There's a Brotherhood's End. There's a land. Yes! Yeah, I know who you're talking about. So, we do this. And then, poof. They go Curse Flat. And I'm not going to play the Brotherhood's End here, because I like my Power Stones. So I just play the 2-2. But yeah, this is what we do. Yeah, witness up. Yeah, the Jeskai list. So they play... It's she's 3 mana. If you would draw instead, you, yeah, instead of drawing, you would exile the cards instead, which gets around Sheoldred great in the meta. Excuse me. So we're looking great here. This portal is going to let me bring back their Sanctuary Warden, which is pretty fantastic. If it turns into a buffet for our portal, great. Portal to Phyrexia is great. Look at this. I get the Sanctuary Warden now. I'm going to remove the counter from it. Hey, look. I got to go for the throat. Hey, look. I got an Abrade. Hey, look. I got a Blast Zone. Hey, look. I got a Burn Down the House. Hey, look. I can discard and draw cards. I'm going to discard the land. Yeah, Thran Spider. That's actually really good. So we're going to play the Blast Zone in. I'm going to cast in the Thran Spider. We give them a Power Stone as well. And that's fine. I'm going to go for the throat and kill the Architect. But yeah, so this is big red. And I'm going to make a Treasure Token just because. Now, I have enough mana that on my turn, I can use Thran Spider to look at the top cards of my library and grab an artifact. So we just start digging through our deck even more now. This is what big Rakdos is meant to do. No, I opted not to, Chris. I probably could have. Sure, that's fine. Mysterious Limousine, now that's something. It'd be a shame if I had to kill it. Guess I gotta go find the Abrade again, don't I? Oh, that works. There's a Cityscape Leveler. Well. What do I want? I guess I could take the Sarah's Paragon. Nah, Paragon I don't think is actually worth it. You know what? Let's just grab the Spirit of Yeah, you know what? I'll still take the Paragon. My Paragon now. Oh, there's the Gopher Throat. Man, this is just value right now. Love this. Alright, let's play in the land. Let's jam in the Cityscape Leveler. Go ahead and blow up the Mysterious Limousine. They can have their Warden back, that's fine. I'm not worried about it. I will go ahead and play in another Thran Spider. Do I need to play in the Thran Spider? I guess I actually don't. No, I don't think I need to kill the Thran Spider. I should use the Go for the Throat, though, so I remove that last point off the Sanctuary Warden. And I could burn down the house right now, but I'm going to wait. I think there's still more value I can get with Burn Down. And quite frankly, burn down hurts my board more than theirs. So we can wait. How much mana do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana open. So I have 6 mana open. I can't do Thran Spider. I stand corrected. I can now. Let's just grab a mountain. Well, I can activate Thran Spider now before we switch phases. That's kind of helpful. And then Reflection can make a copy of the Cityscape Leveler. Unless they just lay down the arms, that's unfortunate. But I'll just go ahead and do this and go find another one, I suppose. Ooh, Skitter Beam. Ooh, Flesh Gorger. Ooh, that's a tough one. What one do I take? I guess Flesh Gorger. Yeah, let's do Flesh Gorger. Unfortunate about that exile, but you know, Flesh Gorger is pretty sweet. Well, the thing I do too, my only reason for taking the Flesh Gorger is because Skitter Beam, when you copy it, I only get another 4/4. With Flesh Gorger, I'm gonna get so much more. Right? Look at all these great triggers we've got. I like your Spirited Companion. Thank you. I love this. This is great. Let's draw a card. That's a land, that's fine. And we got a land, another Thran Spider, and another leveler. Oh, that's so fancy. Then I guess we just go cast my leveler, blow up the warden. You can have a power stone. Kiki makes a copy of the leveler, and then we get the concede. So there's game one. So I thought they were the wedding announcement control list. Looks like it's a mono white. Mid-range? So I like bringing in another Flesh Gorger here over the battalion. Reason being is the menace, because they're going to have targeted spells, it seems. And that ward pay 7 life is kind of huge. I still want to keep 3 Brotherhood's Ends and 3 Burn on the houses. I'm not sure, but I could bring in the Duresses. So maybe it's bring in the Duresses, we cut both Disfigures, and cut one Go for the Throat. And then we just have some good hand information we can force discard. So I think we'll run it back that way. Oh, we'll do those changes. Five lands and double Brotherhood's End. Yeah, I can look at that. Also, we have Blast Zone. Ooh, turn one Duress. All right. Let's go. What are we taking here? A Farewell, an Emperor, and a Bankbuster? Yeah, goodbye. No question. I can deal with the Bankbuster. I have Brotherhood's End for that. I'm not worried about that hand, right? This clears Emperor, this clears Bankbuster. That, however, that is a nuisance. That wrecks my board and everything. Ooh, Flesh Gorger. I'll just play on the Haunted Ridge tapped here, I think. Now, bearing in mind that the Emperor can come down and potentially get plus, I think I am going to have to play the Gorger on 3. Go down to 19 here. But that doesn't necessarily mean that I have to attack. Just that I have to prototype. Because now this deters them from attacking. And I'm doubtful they play any spells here, which is good for my turn. So I can just play in this Mishra's Bounty. Do I play in the second Gorger? I could. I think I'm just going to pass.
Nah, let's put it in, actually. We'll drop in both. They five pin the Emperor. And here they'll make a 2-2. I've learned much during this travel. Oh, didn't make a 2-2. Thought they would have. 2-2 gets fundamentally bigger at this point. I guess plus one again. That's fine. Show them how we greet our- the restoration of a Ganjo. Do play in the Bank Buster. That is helpful. Didn't go for the attack. Which means that they're hoping to crew the Bank Buster. So I can't use Go for the Throat on the Bank Buster, but I can clear that ambitious farmhand. So let's just go ahead and pop the farmhand now. Force them to crew. Hey, what's going on, Quick? Hey, what's going on, Cosmic? Welcome in both. How you doing? Happy Friday. How is your day going, my friends? Hope it is good. And from here, I'm just going to hold back and pass the turn. How is everyone doing, though? What is going on? We are playing some big Rakdos right now against a mono-white mid-range beast. Get back to the farmhand. So we discarded a plains to bring back the farmhand to fetch another plains. Get some tasty chicken. Nice, Cosmic. So they're going to get up to 6 lands here. Unfortunately, I can't Brotherhood's End twice. Much as I would love to. Ah, they're going to play the Prince that way. So this is the opponent's board, right? There's not a lot going on to it. Problem with using the Brotherhood's End right now is it doesn't kill everything. That is almost a leveler. That puts me at 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana. I need 2 more for the leveler. If I attack him with the Flesh Gorgers, they just prove the Mank Buster. That puts me at a severe disadvantage. If I use Brotherhood's End to destroy artifacts, I'll be in a awkward spot too. So I think the right play here is just at the moment past the turn. What would you say is more exciting, Dominary Master or Phyrexia Old One? It depends on what you're looking to enjoy, Cosmic, right? So if you're looking for like a reprint set and everything, 100% Dominaria Remastered is for you. If you're looking for a new set for Standard and new cards in general, Phyrexia All Will Be One. No question. Not the 3-3. I might just be forced to do this, unfortunately. Let's see where they attack. Okay. We will say no blocks. Sure. It's now a 5-5. Yep. Fortunately, that is a little bit troublesome. I'm going to go ahead and put one on here. Bringing back Infectment in a different way? That'd be interesting. You hate Infect. Personally, I like Infect. Portal to Phyrexia. Also really useful if I had the mana. The key here is if I had the mana. I'm forced to attack. This should get them to crew with the Bank Buster, though. I at least gain some life. Maybe they don't. I've been tortured by poison and infect. Ah, that's never fun. It depends on how it's used. If it's used properly to end the game, then it's completely acceptable. We're back to 13. I can do this to deal 3, but then I just die to the rest of the critters, so... That's going to be game 2, unfortunately. We didn't really just get our acceleration of mana to play our big stuff like we did in the last game. Unfortunate. I'm gonna just keep though. We'll try to mull a little bit better. Work to mulligan a bit better and see how that goes. It's a little bit bright. Cool beans. There we go. That's better. All right, so we've got the rest, Thrain Spider, and Burn Down. I'm for it. What am I seeing today? You've got Emperor and double lay down the arms. These don't really scare me. Honestly, the Emperor is a little bit more troublesome. They're not really playing stuff until then. They don't really have any planes either, so... Let me tell you, boy howdy, once I get that portal of Phyrexia rolling, woohoo, are we in a good spot. Have you played Hades? No, I haven't, Cosmic. I've had friends that have. I personally have not tried it yet, though. I hear good things, and it's Greek mythology, which is great. I think I'm just ultimately trying to get up to, yeah, portal. So they got Field of Ruins to go fetch another plane, blow up my Mistress Workshop, whatever. We run tons of basic, we're fine. They got the Emperor, so I don't have to be worried about that. Let's just go ahead and play in another Thrain Spider.
Yeah.
Space Ghost 7414, welcome to the Ember Dragon Legion as a Dragonaut, my friend. I hope your Friday is going fantastic. Please do enjoy your awesome follow emotes. I hope your Friday night is going great. You are our 12th follower of the week, my friend. Welcome, welcome. And we're gonna pass the turn. So they're gonna Field of Ruin, probably my workshop. Just fine. You wanna hydrate? Gotcha, Cosmic, can do. Kind of already have a, I need like a double red source that's not gonna ping me for burn down at the moment, so I'll grab that. But I mean, like, we're getting ramp going here. I can play on this blast zone and actually use the Thrain Spider to go find some artifacts. Ooh, that's a Flesh Gorger. Ooh, I do like that. Let's go ahead and attack with two Thrain Spiders. Huh? Have you seen Ivory Tower and Joker Hunt? No, I haven't, Cosmic. Alright, we'll play in a Flesh Gorger. For sure. You're gonna blow up my Blast Zone? That's perfectly fine. I'll grab a Swamp off this one. Still got a Flesh Gorger coming down. That's perfectly fine. Now you've done it. Hat's coming off. Sure. Again, no worries. I got a Flesh Gorger. And you can't use a lay down the arms on it. That's a farmhand. That's fine. What is Ivory Tower though? I don't know Ivory Tower. So they could lay down my Thrain Spider, I mean, if they really want to. I don't see the vested interest in doing so right now. Lay down's gonna be a much more powerful removal spell. But for them to successfully deal with Flesh Gorger here, they're gonna need like a farewell. So for the moment, I would say we're A-okay, chat. The beginning of your upkeep, X life, or X the number of cards in hand, my sword. Ah! Technically, combo consists of your deck in hand, or relic bar, gaining massive. Okay. That's pretty sweet. I dig that. So there's the laydown. It's gonna get me another mountain here, and I'm gonna go attacking for 7. They're gonna use their land. Oh, my friend, okay. I don't think you know how acceptable that is to me. I am perfectly okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think I'm gonna save the burn down the house. Is them scooping. Ah, that's the only win con? Okay. They didn't play the owl because they used the land. Great for me. I'm gonna play in Karn Living Legacy. I'm gonna go ahead and make another Power Stone token. There's another farmhand to find a plains. This maybe will be a game where I get to ultimate Karn. Wouldn't that be sweet? It's like ultimate Karn and suddenly all my artifacts start paying. That'd be great. I'd be curious to try that kind of combo on Commander. It's not my usual go-to, but it would be interesting to see. Just seeing someone gain butt tons of life in different ways. Sure, I have tokens on. Yeah. Well, for sure I'm doing this. I want another Power Stone token. I want to get Karn to 7. 3, 4, 5. I think I'm just going to make 1/1s. And I'll play in Sokin's on as well. Say no attacks, and I'll just hold back. Should have a new graveyard right now, friend. Sarah's Paragon, sure. Alright, you got a Sarah's Paragon. I guess now is not a bad time to go ahead and portal to part. Ooh, nope, that's a cityscape leveler. Well, let's make a tap Power Stone. We're gonna do a portal to Phyrexia. I'm gonna blow up that Paragon. It's gone forever. I'm gonna go in with a singular 1/1. Two decks that can gain life in Kalia and Bard's Fire Song. Yes. Fire Song and Sunspeaker. I remember that card. You're going to destroy my Sulphur Springs. Sure. Go ahead and just grab another mountain, I guess. So I could minus Karn, have my Power Stones hit for 5 and go in with the leveler. I also kind of want to get this portal to Phyrexia out. Karn's also just a good way to find some value right now, so I'm not sure I want to ditch Karn. I have another one. Ah, there's the farewell. Sure. Well, I guess I can do this. What else you got? Goodbye. Make a Power Stone. It's fine. Farewell's gone for now. That's better for me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If I top deck a land, I can portal here. Oh, hey, look, it's a land. I can portal here. Well, we'll just plus one Karn again. Now they have to sacrifice. Now I get to start bringing back the Sanctuary Warden. Their only way to deal with this is another farewell. Ah, they got it. Well, good on them. I'll just make another Power Stone token at this point. And attack for 2 with Mishra. My Karn's at 10 right now. The fact that they got the second farewell, though. Like, jeez. I may have to dig some mana in.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 10 mana. So I can potentially like dig for 5. And Lathiel? Lathiel's pretty good. My turn. Get a land. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I can dig 6 cards below. 6. Yeah, that's fine. That is a go for the throat. I do think I like that. I could take the Flesh Scorcher, but I like the go for the throat here. Stay next and end the turn. Like, in a battle, I get to start just looking at my cards and grabbing something of X certain mana cost, right? So you're gonna play an owl? Sure. That's fine. Excuse me. Put two? Sure. That's fine. Oops. Owl and Sploosh. Seemed like a greedy play. Loran. Alright, well, goodbye, my Power Stone. That's fine. Well, Karn will go down to 6. You cannot be trusted. 12 on the shelf in front of you. Jeez, I have 6. Nice! That's awesome, Cosmic. Sure, that's fine. Keep blowing up lands and I keep thin in the deck. I don't mind. I have basics for days here. Another mountain. Spirit of Companion. So that's not much of a board stay left. Hey, look, another land. So I have 4, 5, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, I'm gonna dig 6 cards deep again. That's a Portal to Phyrexia or a Brotherhood's End. I think I take the Brotherhood's End. We just wipe the board. Vicious Farmhand. It's fine. They'll get another Plains. We have 34 cards left in our deck and still tons of gas. I've only lost a Portal and double Thranspiders. Hey, look, another Karn. we'll go ahead and minus here. I'm gonna go for another 6. Every step brings victory. Grab a Visions to Phyrexia, and I'll play in the Visions. They're mono white, right? So. Partition's fine, sure. Another removal spell gone, that's fine. Like, they're down to top decking. I generate value. Our opponent's the one kind of on the issue on the sides here at the moment. Hey, look, in a braid. Alright. Visions to Phyrexia. Cast in another Karn. Disenchant, sure, that's fine. Plus one Karn for a tap Power Stone. Let's go. I require more energy. Yeah, Karn can go to 4. That's fine. You're interrupting my work. Again, Karn. This is Karn playable, right? Hey, look, land. We'll go 7 cards deep. Actually, I can afford to go to 8. So let's go to 8. I could grab a Duress. That is kind of nice. I do like Duress. So let's take a look. What's our opponent got here? Goodbye. So that's their laydown gone. I'm gonna just go ahead and abrade that little farmhand. green or white. Pretty even, to be honest, Cosmic. Both white and green are very just strong in that format. They're all about the same. Yeah, let's look at the top six this time, I think, because I have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that's 10, 11, 12, 13. So I'll look at the top six for something that's like 7 mana or less. Let's grab a Flesh Gorger. Playing a Flesh Gorger. We got a 7-5. Restoration for another Plains. You got it. Oh, hey, a Portal to Phyrexia. Well, let's just make a Power Stone token this time. I don't need anything here. And I'm just going to go push 7 damage in. See if I can remember them all. Delay Arm the Two Legacy. Yo, Darth, that's awesome. You remember them all. Making another deck. Cosmic, that's awesome. Do it up. I'm not going to play the Portal to Phyrexia right now. I'm going to hold back. I think it's worth saving. I have no discriminant need to put it down in case there, for whatever reason, is another farewell from the opponent. Which gets, you know, rid of everything again. Remember, bear in mind, we've been through Farewell, right? And there was another Farewell somewhere. Discarded a Soul Partition. No, you discarded a Spirit of Kin, sorry. Sure. Bank Buster. Alright, fine. Bank Buster to draw. You got it. Like, what do you look for here? That has to be a board clear, right? Hey, look, another Flesh Gorger. I'll just make another Power Stone token. Pushing for 7. And playing another Flesh Gorger. I'll pass the turn. Yes, Farewell absolutely is one of the best board wipes. There is no question about that. And we win. We got there. Here you go. I got you back now. We're gonna mulligan. Yeah, this is better. I want to keep the removal, and we'll keep one Flesh Gorger. We can go like Fable, Soldiers. Not a fan of Soldiers. Soldiers is awkward. I don't have any of my board clears. And it's Thalion Curve. Of course it's Thalion Curve. Oh, is this your Siege Veteran on Curve 2? That's gonna suck if it is. Good, just got home with our X Mystery. Very nice. It is Siege Veteran on Curve. You've gotta be kidding me. Wow. That is some luck. We just kill that right now. I don't want them buffing up more stuff. Thalia's whatever. She's annoying. It's 3 damage. It does add up. I have ways to deal with it. Thalia's better. What the crap? Okay, fine. Sure, I'll... Yeah, 13. There's a Disfigure. That's very handy. Is it worth me doing the Fable here? I think I have to go Fable here over the Disfigure. I need a way to dig a bit deeper. Yeah, I need a way just to dig a bit deeper for a board clear. I don't think it's gonna matter. Holy shit. Okay. I guess it's not gonna matter. Yeah, it just straight doesn't matter. Okay. That just straight didn't matter what we did. Alright, well, you're coming in. And you're coming in. And you're coming in. Skitterbeam, go by. Karn, you're not useful in this game. And we're gonna drop in a braid. We're now welcome to Removal Town. Drop a Visions too. Welcome to Removal Town, everyone. We're making sure nothing lives. The name of the game right now. Natural Douglas Fir from Oregon State. Ooh, nice one. Very nice. All right. Come on. 7 feet. Let's go. That's a tree, my friend. That is a tree. All right, clear. 333. You and your soldiers are going down. You hear me? We're taking the play. All right. We got the removal. We got the removal. We got the fate. We're going to keep. The point is I have the removal. That's the big thing. Now, as long as it's not Thalion Curve again, we're fine. We're even better than fine. We have Voltage Surge. I've got enough removal to keep me going for a while. Come on, turn two, Thalion. Don't you even, Maestro. Don't you even. I'm fine taking the two. Actually, no. I want that dead. I'm not going to take the two. I think you just go die. So they have a Resolute Reinforcements in their hand. Guarantee that's what they're going to play here, which means I just play this and... See? Soldiers, I'm going to tell you. You want to pay that too? I don't, no. Life is valuable in this game. Peacekeeper. Aren't you something? All right, sure. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, take Peacekeeper. Name Brotherhood's End. I freaking dare you. I'll just use Go for the Throat. I freaking dare you. I don't really need Leveler, and I can just unearth it, so we're going to trash it. Oh, another Go for the Throat. How quaint. I'm going to tap this. Let's go ahead and do that. That's gone forever. That's gone forever. Let's go ahead and attack. Let's remove those soldiers, they're gone forever. Goodbye, old soldiers, goodbye. What you got now? What you got now? You gonna cast a mural? Huh? You gonna play a mural? Didn't think so. Don't have it in ya. Siege veteran. Oh no no no. Oh no no no. You don't get to keep that. That is a no no, friend. No 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 no. No, no, no. Come to play the game or you play the game? So I've got 3 board clears. I've got a blast zone and 2 Brotherhood's Ends. I think we're good. The Valiant Veteran. Sure. Hey, look, a portal to Phyrexia. Ironically, I think I attack. But I'm not going to. We're gonna wait. Got 6 mana right now. I'm 3 off the portal. I'm not just throwing out a Brotherhood's End to kill a Valiant Veteran. That doesn't work that way. Will, however, take the trade. I don't often use Kiki for copies and stuff. So I take this trait, like that's perfectly fine to me. Peacekeeper. Go ahead, name the Brotherhood's End. I will just blast on the board. Or I could just actually cast the Brotherhood's End. I mean, that is an option too. And it's much cleaner this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2 more mana and I cast the Portal to Phyrexia. And we just take game 2. When you come to the Removal Town, you gotta be prepared. All I'm saying. And we're gonna run it back this way. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be awesome. It's gonna be fantastic. honestly, though, great first game by the opponent. Like, they had the answers to everything. And that one, we found what we needed. Well, I don't know that I'd say they weren't prepared. I think they did the best that they could, given the circumstance. But, like, I had a lot of removal, right? We had a lot of removal. Opponent's going to take the play, soldiers. And I'm going to keep because burn down the house. This is a good, decent blocker for trade. And I just have a bunch of lands. And there's a portal, which is great. So let's just play that in. It is a slow hand. Oh, but opponent's starting slow too. I do like when opponent starts slow. It's even better for me. Yep, so we go to 16. The Guardian of New Benalia. Sure. Play in a Thran Spider. Guardian is annoying, so I have to try to figure out a way to deal with that hand size. Get rid of the Guardian, because Guardian can now just enlist and start attacking through. And that's damage that's hurt. I also need to stop drawing events. I really don't need more. So they're going to enlist the Guardian here. Karn learned that family drama is hell. No. No. What Karn learned from the Brothers War was to Silex. To Silex. Get it? Silex. Silex. Ah. Karn Silex. I'm hilarious. Sorry, you can laugh. It's funny. I know it's great. Yep, there's the discard. There's the clear. May have to make use of this blast zone. But I'm bumped, right? Ooh. Hey, another burn in the house. Oh, frick, I played the wrong land. Whoops, I played the wrong land. Yeah, there's a theory that Karn doesn't make it out of Phyrexia All Will Be One. Yeah, I kind of fumbled that. Whoops. What even was that? Well, that was supposed to be me playing the Blast Zone, which didn't happen. But it's gonna be me now playing Burn Down the House. Forcing another discard on a Guardian. Guardian's what's keeping me dead at the moment. I need to deal with it. So it has to be Fable next turn, I think. I think I need about two turns to stabilize and live. Nice thing, it's only hitting me for two right now. So I'm at six. Opponent missing land drops is kind of big right now. A Flesh Gorger. That will keep me alive. That's a 7-7. That keeps me going. You actually have Protect the Negotiators. So rude. Damn it. I should have just played the Fable. I got greedy. Damn. 7. Well, not technically dead still. That's the big thing. Alright, I'm down to 4. I'm not technically dead. That's not looking good. Again, not technically dead. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I can portal to Phyrexia next turn. To make sure I don't die to Harbin, I kind of need to burn down the house here. Force them to discard another card. And ensure I only take 2 damage. Okay. This is gonna be... We go to 2. I don't like this. My turn. All right. Now I can cast Portal to Phyrexia. Please don't have another Negotiator. No, don't do this to me.
No.
You don't have it. You don't have it. There's no way you have it. You don't have it. They didn't have it. They didn't have it. They didn't have it. Let's get back my good old friend, the Flesh Gorger. They didn't have it. They didn't have it. They didn't have it. Now we're back in this game. They didn't have it. They didn't have it. They didn't have it. We're back in this game. I can't believe we lived. We only lived because of the land. Only reason I'm not dead. I like this hand. This is... We have removal. We have the thing. We have the better thing. I'm going to play in the black first. Blue. That's a problem. If this is mono blue tempo... Mono blue tempo is actually tricky for me. Them counter spells. I'm gonna try to play the Thran Spider here. This might just be make disappear. Oh, it's impulse. All right, that is fine. Didn't play out the Djinn. That makes me worried. So I can't use enough Power Stones to play my Visions of Phyrexia yet for the Make Disappear. So I just kind of sit back for this turn. Poke in for two. And we play the Visions of Phyrexia next turn to play around and Make Disappear. First is fine. Especially if our opponent just goes and has like the Talarian Terror this turn. Kind of even more reason to. I can always go for the throw it. Nothing. Interesting. And discarding? Very interesting. Alright, well, let's attempt to resolve a Visions of Phyrexia. We play around a Make Disappear. They have negates. That's unfortunate. Well, that is kind of what it is. Not much I can do about it. Another impulse. This is the problem with Mono Blue. They run about 8 counter spells between like sideboard, mainboard on things that just hit my key cards. There's the Djinn. Well. Should be Frank. I think I just have to go for the control. Unless I try for the Abrade first, actually. Take the two? You are going to take the two. I'll pass the turn. Slip out the back. Wow, that is annoying. Sure. Alright, that is a protection piece gone. So that's helpful. That does put them down to 3 cards in hand. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So Portal might be able to do its thing. There's the Terror. I go down to 11 here. Only 2 cards in hand. So to take this match, I have to get Burn Down the House to resolve. That's kind of where this is at the moment. So this has to resolve. They go down to 10. It doesn't, they take game one. That's just the state. Fading hope to bounce it. Alright, well that's me not dead yet. He's still not dead. In fact, it's not a counter spell as big. Odawara to bounce it too. Okay. Interesting. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I wish I had hit some lands there though. Doug is cute and yet annoying. Aw. But he's a puppy. What is a puppy? I don't even have the double red, the double wizard's end. Damn. They had just the right answer. Yeah, they take game one. Unfortunate. So, we need duresses and pilfers in this game. We bring in the discard effects and we drop a braids and disfigures and cut down on a fable. But I am going to cut the Brotherhood's ends here as well. They don't really play much for artifacts. And instead, I'm going to bring in Obliterating Bolts. Yeah, we'll bring in Obliterating Bolts, we'll bring in hand, and try that. Mono Blues. Even on the play, Mono Blue for big decks is just awkward. Only 79 cents. That's not bad, Darth. It's actually relatively cheap. Take the play. Yeah. I got Bolton Spider. I'm good with that. Hitting land drops, which is good. Your best thing. Oh, thanks, Ixnay. I appreciate that. Suspicious Stowaway. That's a curious include. I think this is still just going to be Thran Spider. Like, that's fine if it gets through. I can just use Obliterating Bolt on it. That's fine. We'll draw and then discard. No problem. I've seen decks that are playing Stowaway. Personally, I prefer the Surge Engine with, like, Delver. I've had a lot of good luck with Surge Engine and Delver. Thirst. Illy. Okay, well, let's play out in Sokinzon. I've got mana open, so I'm gonna go for the Obliterating Bolt here. Okay. I'm gonna go for the Go for the Throat. How much do you want that dead? Fading Hope, Spider's back is fine. Okay. So when the gate is gone, that's good to know for our burn down the house. We have another Stowaway though. Okay, we get another land anyways. I think I just want to resolve the Karn. So I have 2 mana to play again for a Make Disappear if I have it. It's a negate. It's not. That's good. Let's go ahead and plus 1 make a Power Stone. Impulse, alright. Conan only has what will be 3 cards into 4 next turn. There's a potential one of them's the land, so that'll leave them at 3 cards in hand. Imagine Stowaway is going to go at... You're going at me. Alright, you don't care about me. I combat damage to a player draw. Got you. Okay. Yeah, I did not read that part of the line. That's fine. Discarded a Fading Hope. Alright, good to know. Another Stowaway. Huh. Okay. Well, let's make another Karn of Legacy. Let's go ahead and get a Fable of the Mirror Breaker. And we'll cast in another Thran Spider. Impulse, sure. Getting a lot of draws and sortations. I have to consider that they're looking for like Haughty Djinns and stuff. I'm gonna go to 15 here. I may just burn down the house. Not gonna discard anything. I mean, that being said, my artifacts can pink for one. I can put them on a 4-turn clock right now. But I think the better play for me is to consider the burn down the house right now. After we attack. Push in 4 damage to save a treasure. He might, Chris. It's distinctly possible. And I mean, if it happens, I mean, kudos. Like, kudos on it. I think I just burned down to make sure this is a clear board now. Consider? Sure. I'd love to top deck a Duress. I think that would be great. Slip out the back. Shh, that's annoying. So we managed to remove one, right? And that's a slip out the back gone. Then you punch Karn? No, you want to do punch Karn. Interesting. Okay, Karn dead, that's fine. There's a Terror. Only 2 cards in hand. I think I just go for it. Oh, and it lands. Oh, and it lands. Beautiful. That felt good. Ah, another Talarian Terror. Get game 2. All right. So, we're happy with our changes, right? We've already got our discard effects that we want in. I'm not really concerned about much else. I keep it in. You were calling it though, Chris. It's true. We saw two. And like, I was ready just to start attacking with our own 5/5s. As long as we had blockers, we were in a good position. So we had a couple 2-tier turns and throwing just tons of damage at the opponent. They can't deal with that onslaught at that point between Kiki and making copies of Talarian. So we are looking for discard effects if we can find them. I don't like mulling past 6 if I can avoid it with this deck. Just hurts hand way too much. So 7 and 6 cards. If 7's not good, we'll go to 6 and try to make 6 playable and workable. Which looks like I'm going to have to do because that's not going to get me anywhere. And these are just too much. This is workable. I'm actually going to ditch Karn because visions. And do a consider on the main. Oh, okay. Didn't even wait. This impulse? Is okay, sure. Digging hard. So lack of answers in hand, maybe? Could just be some lands, like 1 or 2 removal spells. They never play out Jhin on an empty board. So we can try to play out a Thran Spider and bait out like a Make Disappear. Go for Consider again. Okay. Power Stone. And then what? Baiting Ho. Wow. That is aggression. Do they just not have anything? They don't even have a land drop. Oh, that's kind of big. We can just play in a Thran Spider again. Scatter's fine. Oh, wow. It's kind of big. There's the Terror. So to make sure we don't die to a Terror, we go ahead and go for the throat. Then pay the ward cost.
And we still have enough for Make Disappear and the other. They have Fading Hope to bounce. All right, fine. That's fine. And that's just an answer gone. So consider two. All right, so only two mana. So I should just be able to play in this Fable, or this Vision, sorry. Just be able to play in Visions and stick it in. Okay, the two. Accelerate the Power Stones. Now we can do Fable next turn. Sticky, you say. I mean, it's a sticky situation. There's a land. No, another land. All right. Let's do land from hand. I'm going to let that turn into a Power Stone. We're going to attempt to cast the Fable. Fine with that. Play a Visions in. We have two Visions with two more Power Stones. That's two additional cards now a turn. Go down to 10. There's a Djinn. Uh-oh. I need a kill spell here. That's not a kill spell. That's a Duress. That's not a kill spell. It's not a kill spell either. I just died to the Djinn. Duress, you have an answer. I do still have an out. It's not a great out, but I still have an out. Okay, Spell Pierce and Negate. Ditch the Negate. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cast in Karn. Pay one, pay two, resolve. In the top three cards of my deck, there has to be a Go for the Throat. Damn. That's unfortunate. Didn't get there. Ah! That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. I needed a Go for the Throat on the Djinn. Yeah, it's that blows. All right. Well, it happens. We'll queue it back up. I'm only gonna do like one or two more games of Big Rakdos, and then we'll call it done. I'm happy with the list. It's done. It's cool stuff. Would love to see like one. Just, we were so close to just getting that in. A portal would have been great. I mean, the negate sucked on it, but like drawing portal would have been awesome. Getting burned down instead of through Karn would have been fine. Betty, welcome in. Happy Friday, friend. How you doing today? Opponent goes first, but we have Fable. I'm gonna keep. I think I can at least. If this is an aggro, I can take the hand slow. And it looks like it's mid-range, and it's Grixis. I know to start it's Dimmer, it could be Dimmer control, but... Oh, no, it's Esper. Alright. Opponent is playing outside of the norms. I don't like it. Esper's manageable. But can be awkward. I think we just kind of need to seem like we're, mid-range list to start, unless this is okay. Not into Sheholdren, at least on that particular turn. Discarded our refute. So we're gonna go to 18. There's a Go for the Throat. Okay. To a Tenacious Underdog. I think my answer is I want to dig deeper in cards, so it's going to be Flesh Gorger.
And a portal of Phyrexia I'm discarding. Trying to get. Oh, there's a burn down the house. Only my little treasure goblin was still alive today. Playing a swamp, playing a fable. Now, hopefully, they don't buff Rafine on this attack. That's the downside. They buff. Well, let's go burn down the house out of range. That stinks. I have to block 10ED. Into an Almadon's guy. Yikes. Well. That's. I need something different. I don't even know what I'm gonna get. Nope, that is game one to the opponent. I just don't beat that. Burn down wouldn't save me enough. I was just gonna kill me. So, next game. We're gonna run it back. No change. Sucked. I mean, I kept a slow hand. I don't question that. Like, Fable is usually good enough to keep. It's unfortunate it went that route into a Rafine. At least it wasn't a She-Holtred. But... I should have mulliganed. Good mulligan, chat, but we didn't. That's alright. That's what the next round's for. Alright, that's what game two is for. This is our makeup game. This is where we come back. This is where we take the play. This is where we see three Fable of the Mirror Breakers, and everything's fine in the world. As soon as we get that third land, it's all coming up. It's all gonna be great, right? We got removals, we just need that third land off the top, and it's gonna be all wheat. It'll be awesome. We got a 10ED out. I don't like it. It's gonna get removed. We go for that Abrade, we draw the third lands, right? Easy. And then it's just Fable. It's just Fable, Fable, Fable into Portal of Phyrexia and call it a day. Love it. Get a land? Beautiful. Don't discard anything. Playing a land, playing a Fable. Benny, how is your Friday going, friend? Attack for a treasure. And look, it's going great. This is beautiful. This Portal of Phyrexia is going to be the best thing ever. Oh, yeah. Not to mention, I just have three Fables. There's that Rafine. Oh, you are attacking. Alright, that's fine. We just let this go through. We're not worried. This is fine. This is only two damage. We're fine. Got rid of a destroy. Alright. Alright, it's my turn. We get a land. So that's 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm gonna submit 0. I still really like this hand. And yeah, I am just gonna go pushing some damage here. We're gonna go to blockers. Go ahead and go for the throat. Kill that Rafine there and get in some damage. Just made a new standard deck. Nice, Cosmic. That's awesome. Attack me. No blocks. I'll take the 3. That's acceptable. They're gonna draw a card here. My turn. Now, this is where this just gets weird. I'm gonna push in for 2. You're gonna Gonjo. Look at all this treasure. This is great. I can actually afford to play in another Fable. This is usually not how this deck goes, but, you know, this is where we are. Again, Fable of the Mirror Breaker, balance card, chat. Balance card. We're going to go to combat. That's perfectly fine. Don't go to combat. We're gonna make some reflections, I guess. Another reflection. Another reflection. Another reflection. Usually how this works, but you know, make another reflection. Another reflection. Make another reflection. Make another reflection. Discard no cards. Copy my little treasure goblin. Copy my little treasure goblin. Get a bunch of treasures. See combat happen. Sure. Make a samurai. Sure. May your blade strike true. You know, sometimes Fable of the Mirror Breaker just wins a game. So, I guess this time around, we're going to bring in Duresses because we're on the draw. I didn't see a Bankbuster, I don't think. So I'm going to cut the Abrades for the Duresses. And I will cut one Thran Spider. Actually, we'll cut the Skitter Beam Battalion. Keeping the value here. And pass it. Turns out a good... Yeah, exactly, EK. It turns out it's a good card. You know, it just... It's a good card. So two lands, but I do have Disfigure, Brotherhood's End, Burnout, and Visions. Hey, what's going on, Jess? Happy Friday. How you doing? Also, EK, happy Friday, friend. How you doing today, too? We're gonna just kind of try to lead. I have a good amount of board clear. I just need to hit some lands. Hopefully hit some lands. Announcement's fine. Alright, there's a land. I don't need to burn down the house right now. We can just pass. Sorry, I don't need to Brotherhood's End right now is what I mean. I will just figure, kind of reduce some damage at the moment. And I'm going to attempt to get down this Visions of Phyrexia. I'm good, what about you? I'm doing good, Jess, I'm doing good. How's your Friday today? I know you're doing good, but what you getting up to? EK, are you feeling better, my friend? I hope you're doing better. Flash in the Wandering Emperor. No sweat. Good thing I have burned down the houses. Oh, and Brotherhood's Ends. Slowly, slowly. Dude, I'm glad. I am glad. So they're going for the card draw here. That's perfectly fine. into an Owl of the Dawn Sky. Tapping out, so I need a land here. It's not a land, nor is that. This does help me, though, because I can duress. Don't like that. And I quite frankly want your other things gone. So Owl being left alive, bit of a problem at the moment. However, Burn Down the House still keeps me in this. Again, just need to draw that land. And we get it. So now I can just go Burn Down the House. And Owl dies. Oh, you top decked the negate. Oh, that's unfortunate. That is unfortunate for me. Well, guess I go to 5. Play in this land and burn down the house again. Get a wedding announcement. Sure, that is totally fine. Alright, Denik has flying. That's an issue. 3, 4, 5, 6. I'd love to get, I guess, a flush over to keep me alive. That'll take me down to 1. Not dead, but that'll take me to 1. Okay. There's a land. That'll at least let me cast in Cityscape Leveler, which I can blow up the Denik with. Broke is fine, because now I just attacked 7. And then you have to with Gonjo. Yep. And then boom, I heal right back to 8. Got. And I'm just gonna play in another Flesh Gorger. Hey, what's going on, Dingleberries? How you doing? Welcome in, friend. Pass the turn. 15 and 2 with Phyrexian. Yo, that's awesome, Dingles. Way to go. Alright, it's up to my turn now. We're gonna bring in our good friend, the Cityscape Leveler. We're gonna go to attack. I'm gonna go ahead and blow up a wedding announcement. And there's the concede. Good game. Please remember to hit the like and subscribe button, and Dragonauts, keep leaving. I'll see you next time.